जिंदगी की शाम है और उस पे तन्हाइयां। जिंदगी की शाम है और उस पे समझे हमारे दर्द की गहराइयां। जिंदगी की शाम है और उस पे ये किया देकर जिन्हें हमने सुनाया था कभी, थाम कर उंगली जिन्हें चलना सिखाया था कभी। अजनबी संसार से परिचय कराया था कभी, आज हम उनके लिए ही बन गए परछाइयां। जिंदगी की शाम है और उस पे ये तन्हा।
She's Asha Devi. In her prime, Asha Devi worked quite selflessly, helping her husband, bringing up children, doing all routine household works. The modest family income did not dissuade her from sending her children to good schools and colleges. Asha Devi is a satisfied person today. She gets her share of love and affection from all members of the family. In the Indian social milieu, there is no dearth of happy and satisfied old people like Asha Devi. But the overall picture is not so bright. A significant percentage of the senior citizens in our country, both women and men, have no support coming from their respective families or from other sources. These people have no realm of respect, originally built on the famous Indian joint family system, rooted deep in the traditional values. The collapse of the joint family system actually has led to a pathetic trend that keeps on forcing the old ones feeling insecure socially as well as economically. The fear of death is their constant partner, but they are more afraid of losing company of their children or grandchildren. This makes their life really miserable. We, the younger generation, have developed an unsympathetic tendency towards our elderly due to our misplaced impression that they are of no use. This consumerist attitude of ours has turned the older people's plight into misery at several levels, from physical to social, social to economic, economic to cultural, cultural to emotional, emotional to psychological, and so on and so forth.
बचपन से ही दुखी है, पूरा दुखी दुख में काटा जा, दुखी दुख में जिंदगी कट गई।
क्या बताऊं, क्यों हो रहा, अच्छा ही हो रहा, बहुत बढ़िया हो रहा, टाइम पास हो रहा, क्या बताएं आपको।
Due to my थ्री सन्स उनकी नॉन कॉपरेशन से आई हैव टू सफर दिस।
हम दुखी इस वजह से क्योंकि हम यहाँ पर अकेले रहते हैं, हमारे पास में कोई देखने वाला नहीं है।
ऐसा भी जब बीच बीच में मैं जाती आती थी निकाल देती थी।
द ओल्ड पीपल डिड नॉट फेस सच पैथेटिक एंड हॉरिबल कंडीशंस व्हेन पीपल्स लाइव्स डिपेंडेड प्योरली ऑन एग्रीकल्चर रिसोर्सेज। दोज डेज लाइफ वाज सिंपल, इंटीग्रेटेड बाय द जॉइंट फैमिली सिस्टम एंड अकॉम्पनिंग वैल्यूज। The older persons were not only the heads of their respective families, but also enjoyed lots of respect in their social milieu. Today, the essential evils of the so-called modernism like consumerism has distorted the social fabric, particularly in the urban areas. Members of the younger generation are moving to places far away from their homes in search of better job opportunities. This has forced the older family members to stay back in the company of depression born out of loneliness in their own homes or in the homes for the people like them.
Hamara desh tarakki to kiya hai, lekin is tarakki ke sath sath jo joint family system tha wo taqreeban khatam sa ho gaya hai. Maan lijiye Delhi ke jo yuvak hain wo naukri karne ke liye ye bahar chale jate hain, किसी हमारी कंट्री में ही या किसी बाहर के देश में। ऐसे उनके बाहर जाने से उनके माँ बाप पीछे जो हैं आज के दिन अकेले रह जाते हैं, उनकी देखभाल करना वैसे ही मुश्किल हो जाता है।
Here, the endless journey of their plight begins. The loneliness and depression lands some of these old people into the trap of psychological problems. Most of the people in these homes are lonely, no matter how many equally fated old people are around. They are not ready to accept the new reality very easily.
Commonest psychological problems of old age in almost everybody as a normal experience. The commonest two are dementia and depression. Dementia is the loss of memory that might occur at 80 or 90 years of age, when it occurs early at 60 or 65 years of age. With loss of memory, then gradually there is lack of intellectual functioning and lack of day-to-day ability to live. Depression is the other more common, in fact, problem. And the depression in old age is related to the psychological factors that we spoke about, the disability, as well as the fact that there is very little to occupy the mind. Old age depression is much more common than we recognize, from mild to the most severe nature. It's also important that we used to believe that suicide is not very common in old age, and that's wrong. Attempted suicide and completed suicide is known in old age, and so there is need to be careful about that.
Also, it is not simple to adjust to the new environment and not feel neglected and discarded. The cutthroat competition has increased the woes of the older segment of society further. Even if the old people move to the new places with the young ones, they find it difficult to adjust to the new environs, where people are alien, where cultures are unfamiliar, and languages incomprehensible. The problem becomes worse when these old people's value system does not allow them to change with the times. Those who have no support coming from any source are the worst sufferers. Most of them do not even enjoy their basic rights to food, potable water, proper clothes, shelter, and healthcare in secure environments. These poor old people succumb more easily to the diseases.
Most of the cases that we get are of hypertension, diabetes, osteoarthritis, cases of cataract, then cases like loose motions, fever. Then we do get people loss of memory cases, fungal infections of the skin. We get cases like scabies, arthritis.
With their compound physical problems, they have no choice but to find solace in these old age homes. In several cases, the hapless old people are just dumped at the doorsteps of the old age homes or care centers, not by the strangers, but by their own children or grandchildren, for whom these old ones cared so much when they were young. It is strange that we tend to forget that getting old is but a cycle, and one day we too will be victims of old age. In India, there are several types of old people, but the three major categories include people, those who never worked in their lives and have no idea either about their survival, those who are still forced to work in order to fend for themselves, and thirdly, those who worked all through their lives and managed to save some money for their old age, as most part of it went in getting their children educated and married. These financially comfortable old people remain exposed to constant threats, the threat of being robbed or getting killed. The newspapers are full of cold-blooded murder stories. Quite often, the blind greed for money is taking the toll on the older persons who actually deserve respect from everybody.
Everybody look for the soft targets, and criminal also look for the soft targets. Nobody would like to, attack a person, grapple with him and then take the money. A criminal like that, if he is softly giving the money handed over to him, he would like that. Senior citizens, because of their aloneness, because of their exposure and because of their helplessness, because they are, most of them are living alone, most of them are not living with their family, so they are more exposed, they are more vulnerable.
On the other hand, there are old people who would not necessarily feel threatened but have no shelters at all. The only support the hapless have is deprivation. In many places, we find old people living in subhuman conditions with no proper shelter, despite the fact that the Supreme Court of India has interpreted the right to shelter to be a part of the constitutional fundamental right to life. The current data suggests that India is one of the youngest countries in the world, as the largest part of its population being less than 35 years old. In the year 2050, one out of these five young people will be 60 years older, and majority of older persons will be women. This suggests that the ultimate victims of the old age are more women than men. The number of centenarians aged 100 years or above will also increase 15-fold by 2050. Just imagine how the society of that time will tackle this situation. Keeping the future situation in mind, the government and the non-government organizations have already started to address the problem and recognize the fact that these very old people need special attention and respect. Keeping all these alarms in perspective, the United Nations General Assembly adopted the principles of older persons.
In 1982, there was a huge meeting of the World Assembly on Aging, which was held in Vienna and adopted the Vienna Plan of Action. This was followed 10 years later in 2002 in Madrid, which adopted a political declaration and the Madrid Plan of Action. All the governments of the world committed themselves to doing something for the aged, for the elderly people, and pledged to integrate the aged who form part of vulnerable groups into their government and national policies.
According to these principles, older persons should have access to adequate food, water, shelter, clothing and healthcare to help them maintain or regain the optimum level of physical, mental and emotional well-being, and to prevent or delay the onset of illness even as they remain integrated in society. The decision to observe 1999 as the International Year of Older Persons has been part of the UN commitments. 1st of October is also observed as the International Day of the Older Persons. The issue of human rights of the elderly is one area of grave concern. The Union Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment has recognized and acknowledged the need to assist senior citizens in many areas.
National Policy on Older Persons was adopted in 1999. It is a national policy statement. It provides the base for interventions wherever necessary, and also to oversee the implementation of various schemes. And also the policy issues laid in the document.
If the children neglect the parents and the senior citizens, they can be sent to the prison, imprisonment for 1 month. If a children intentionally abandon their parents somewhere with the hope their parents will not come back home, they will be put before the tribunal. The tribunal can give 3 months imprisonment.
The self-help groups have also evolved their strategies over the years. The self-help groups are broadly functioning in cities where retired and educated people are in the lead. They help other older people overcome psycho-emotional sufferings and pains. A concerned section of the civil society has also been playing an important role in facilitating the self-help groups.
अगर हम किसी तरह से हर एक कॉलोनी में एक सीनियर सिटीजंस वेलफेयर एसोसिएशन बना सकें और वो एसोसिएशन के मेंबर्स पहले अपनी मुश्किलात आपस में ही हल करें जहां तक हो सके, ये सीनियर सिटीजंस जो कॉलोनीज में रहते हैं उनको किसी तरह से सेक्टोरल ग्रुप्स में बनाया जाए। सेक्टोरल ग्रुप से मतलब है एक ग्रुप जिसमें के एक सीनियर सिटीजन के साथ दूसरे सीनियर सिटीजन, चाहे वो फ्रेंड्स हों या नेबर्स हों या उनके रिलेशंस हों, जो उनकी मदद को जरूरत पड़ने पर आ सके।
इन बिग सिटीज सिक्योरिटी ऑफ सीनियर सिटीजन इज अनदर एरिया ऑफ कंसर्न।
हर आदमी को अपनी सेफ्टी की सिक्योरिटी केयर करनी चाहिए, बुजुर्गों को खासकर, क्योंकि वो इजी टारगेट्स हैं। इस बारे में बहुत काफ़ी संख्या में हमने कैंप लगाए, लोगों को बताया, जगह जगह बुजुर्गों का सेमिनार किया, सम्मेलन किया। बहुत सारी एनजीओज हैं जिनके साथ हम जाते हैं, हमारे पास काफ़ी लिटरेचर है। इसको अगर ब्रॉड कैटेगरी में देखा जाए तो हमने ये माना है कि घर के अंदर और घर से बाहर क्या उनको केयर करनी चाहिए।
लेटली द रेजिडेंट्स वेलफेयर एसोसिएशंस हैव इवॉल्व्ड द नेबरहुड केयर मैकेनिज्म wherein neighbors take care of each other's elderly members or look after those senior citizens who live all alone. This mechanism has tremendously helped in strengthening the social bond as well. Professional caregivers are increasingly in demand in urban areas. Light exercises also keep the old people slightly away from the process of fast aging. The light games confer on the elderly a sense of purpose and achievement.
व्यायाम करना बहुत ज़रूरी होता है, क्योंकि उसमें जितना मैक्सिमम पॉसिबल फिटनेस है वो मिलता है। तो उसमें कोई इन्फेक्शन भी हो जाए या कोई चोट भी लग जाए तो हीलिंग में बेस्ट सर्कमस्टांसिस क्रिएट हो जाते हैं।
One must also stay intellectually engaged, be it chess or carom or any community service. To bring back enthusiasm, inspiration and holistic mental health to life, the laughter clubs are an easy way out. It is truly said that laughter is the best medicine.
I feel old at all. I don't know why do you call me old. I'm only 85.
There is no dearth of those who can teach yoga, and that too free of cost.
Yoga sadhana is very, very important for the aged persons, senior citizens. Yoga or yogic practices will help to overcome the disorders of aging process.
In other words, the holistic approach, meditation, devotional and spiritual music, yoga, prayers and hymns, etc., can address physical, psychological as well as spiritual urges of the old people. Appropriate nutritious food in correct proportion and adequate amount is also a must for the old ones. To give them the sense that they are still useful to the society, they must be provided with the opportunities where they can impart knowledge. Old people in old age homes like doctors, professors, scientists and journalists could be encouraged to share their knowledge and experiences with those fellow inmates born with lesser fortunes. The economic pressures make more and more members of the urban families look out for work. In such situations, the children of these families are left alone at homes. The elderly can play their role of grandparenting in these families. In turn, the youngsters will recognize how valued their grandparents are to them. The older people actually deserve the kind of care we extend to the children. To make this possible, we need to have a paradigm shift in our approach towards the elderly, which means the society as a whole, including the young people like us, have to be sensitized towards its senior citizens so that the people give them the kind of respect and love they deserve. Diminishing traditional joint family system also needs to be strengthened.
गवर्नमेंट तो जो काम करती है वो करती ही है, लेकिन उसके साथ जो वॉलंटरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हैं उनको भी इस क्षेत्र में काम करना चाहिए, और स्वैच्छिक संस्थानों और कॉर्पोरेट जो है कॉर्पोरेट्स इनको भी ये सपोर्ट करना चाहिए कि इस प्रकार के जो स्वैच्छिक संस्थान कार्य कर रहे हैं वृद्धों के लिए उनको उनको आर्थिक मदद वो दें।
आफ्टर ऑल वी बिलोंग टू अ सोसाइटी दैट हैज बीन रिकॉग्नाइज्ड द वर्ल्ड ओवर फॉर इट्स जॉइंट फैमिली सिस्टम एज वेल एज फॉर आवर वैल्यूज that service to the humanity is service to the God.
Every younger generation realizes that it's a cycle. A young person today is going to be an old person tomorrow. That is one. And second thing is a young person has to think from two accords. One, to take care of the elderly person who enabled them to have a good youth which they are having today. It is their investment which they are reaping today. So therefore, it's their moral duty as well as a return to the well-being of their own, that they should look after the elderly persons.
The youngsters must remember that the elders brought us up and enabled us to survive in this harsh world. And now, it's our turn to pay back.
अभी हमें ज़रूरत है ये समझने की कि इस एज पर हमारे पेरेंट्स की क्या ज़रूरत है, उन्होंने इतने साल जो काम किया है उनकी भी ज़रूरत है कि वो भी रेस्ट करें, और हम उनकी अब हम क्योंकि हम अपने पैरों पर खड़े होने वाली स्टेज पर आ चुके हैं तो हम उनकी मदद करें, पूरी तरह से समझें कि उनको अब क्या चाहिए।
So ensure that the old people, irrespective of their class and creed, are safe, secure and sound in the hands of new generation. Only then the sufferings of the senior citizens will be a thing of the past, and that for certainty is going to be a new beginning.
Honor the elderly, honor your future. If you honor your elderly today, you would be honoring in fact your future.
बुजुर्गों का अनुभव युवाओं की ताकत मिलकर बनाएगा नया एक भारत।
आपको ये प्यार देना और लेना आना चाहिए, and then the world rocks with you.
मिले प्यार